Good afternoon. Thanks for coming. My name is Antonio Acevedo. I work in the Office of Human Rights, Division of the County Manager's Office. Welcome to this Hispanic Heritage Month opening celebration. This was created in 1968 by President Lyndon Johnson, and then by Proclamation in 1989, we started celebrating here in Arlington County this feast, this celebration where our culture, our food, our dances are shown and exhibited for the benefit of all of us and those who are not that familiar with our culture. I'm going to introduce the president of Alianza, which is the Alliance of Hispanic Employees of Arlington County Government. Her name is Maribel Contreras. She works in human resources. Maribel, come over.
Thank you. Buenas tardes y bienvenidos. I am Maribel Contreras, president of Alianza for the term of 2016-2018. And on behalf of the organization, I'm excited to welcome you to this year's proclamation of the Hispanic Heritage Month. As many of you know, this annual event has been hosted by Alianza and celebrated by the county since 1989. The county manager and the county board give us an opportunity to be united here in this great celebration. This year, our theme, Embracing, Enriching, and Enabling America, gives us the opportunity to demonstrate the many contributions our diverse background brings to this country and to Arlington County. As many Hispanics look for a better opportunity and immigrate to the United States, we recognize that we are well received by many and take the opportunity to embrace this new land with values shared by all. Love for our family, respect for our neighbors, co-workers and communities in general. Hard work to provide for our families and hospitality to share a smile, a hand, and of course, the best way we know how, with food and music. As we embrace the United States as newcomers and as native-born citizens, our Hispanic cultures continue to strive to make the United States of America a great place to live and work. Sometimes we work very, very hard, but always to achieve our goal for the future. We Hispanics and the members of Alianza continue to believe in that American dream. We believe that it will lead us to achieve self-determination, liberty, and that pursuit of happiness cherished by many who have come before us to fulfill their dreams. The rich cultures we share as Hispanics allows us to bring our own traditions, ethics, and values to our community and enrich them with the passion needed to continue the commitment to serve and to make our workplace, community, family, and this country better every day. Our culture also enables greatness through contributions in the areas of business, including the service area, in our nation's defense, the arts, sports, our public sector, and in organizations for profit and nonprofit. These are only some of the many areas where talent and hard work is supported by great missions and values. In Arlington County government, Hispanics are represented in every department. They contribute to Arlington's vision to provide great service and continue a diverse and exclusive world-class urban community. Today, as we embrace, enrich, and celebrate Hispanics in America, let us join together in support of each other and guide our future paths, creating a legacy for a culture in Arlington County that will be the framework for a workplace we all endure. We thank you very much and are honored to have you join us today. We hope you celebrate the month-long celebrations and participating in the events that Alianza has lined up. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Maribel. No one else could have said it better. Now I'm going to ask Arlington Finest, our County Honor Guard, representatives of the Sheriff Office, Police Department, and Fire Department to come forward to present the national colors. Please remain standing. We're going to call forward Mayuri Loza Munoz. She's a student of the Arlington County Public School System. She's an honor student. She's a member of the theater club. She's also a member of Teatro La Luna at Gunston. And she also is very active in the community, helping those with limited English proficiency and also participating in programs to assist the homeless. Mayuri will be singing the national anthem, and she's also our sign language interpreter, so she will do it both ways. Mayuri, thank you very much for that beautiful interpretation. We have a friend in the county board who always assists us with the Pledge of Allegiance. Her name is Liza Hutchins. Liza, are you here? Go ahead. You're going to recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please join with me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Color, right, face, forward, off.
Let's give a hand to the Arlington Finest. And you can please be seated. We would like to ask the county board members to stand as I identify them so that those employees who do not know them may have an opportunity to know who you are. I'm going to ask the chair, Libby Garvey, to stand up. You can give her a hand. Jay Fissett, the vice chair. Katie Crystal. If anyone else shows up, I'll introduce them too. We also have two other board members, Christian Dursey and John Vistad, but they're not here today. The county manager is not here with us, but we have a representative here, Carol Mitten. She is the deputy county manager who's representing him. Now we're going to have a folkloric dance, and we have another interesting person. His name is Fernando Rochas. He's a senior at Woodland Secondary Program, and he will perform a folkloric dance for us.
Ay, qué bonito es bailar, eso es el chilingo lingo, que lo saben zapatear, tanto chino como el gringo.
Ay, qué bonito es bailar, eso es el chilingo lingo, que lo saben zapatear, tanto chino como el gringo.
Ay, repica, pica, pica, repica y repiqueteando, qué bonita, todas las que están bailando.
Ay, tilín, 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 ay, tolón, 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 qué bonitas las hijas de los.
Fernando, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now I'm going to call the chairman of the board, the chairperson of the board, Libby Garvey, and the vice chair, Jay Fissett. And they are going to read for us the 2016 Hispanic Heritage Month Arlington County Proclamation. These are the two leaders of our county board, and I'm going to leave them with you.
All right, I'll take this. We're going to do a tag team very quickly up here, but again, on behalf of the county board, welcome today. And I did want to introduce one other elected official that I know is in the room, is Barbara Kennanen, the vice chair of the Arlington School Board. So, Barbara. Okay, this is our Hispanic Heritage Month proclamation. Again, tag team. I'll read the first four whereas clauses. Whereas the Hispanic presence and influence in the United States of America dates back to the early 1500s. And whereas Latinos have participated throughout the history of the United States in support and defense of the principles and ideals upon which this country was founded. And whereas Hispanics have made significant contributions in all phases of our economic, social, cultural, and political life. And whereas Latinos account for approximately 15% of Arlington's population and number more than 50 million residents in the United States. And
I have a microphone. So I'm going to do it on Espanol. Disculpen mi español. Considerando que los hispanos constituyen un grupo diverso de son originarios de 21 países de habla hispana, cuya herencia de los une con Norteamérica, Centro y Sudamérica, las islas del Caribe, África y Europa, y considerando que los latinos contribuyen a la diversidad y unidad de Arlington con su riqueza histórica y cultural, así como las diversas etnicidades dentro de nuestras comunidades latinas, y considerando que nosotros como comunidad y como gobierno estamos orgullosos de la riqueza cultural que han traído con su diversidad los inmigrantes hispanos, por lo tanto, yo, Libby Garvey, presidente de la Junta de Gobierno del Condado de Arlington, Virginia, proclamó que desde el 15 de septiembre hasta el 15 de octubre de 2016 se celebrará el mes de la herencia hispana en el Condado de Arlington y aliento a todos los ciudadanos y unirse y apoyar la celebración del condado de la rica herencia de nuestros residentes hispanos.
Not bad, huh?
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much, Libby. How can we not, how we cannot love these people? I'm telling you. Barbara Comstock, I really remiss if I not ask you to stand up, because I was going to introduce you right after this, because I know you're here. So please, she's a member of the Arlington County Board. School Board. I'm sorry, School Board, yes. We have some department heads here. Anita Friedman there. And we have Jay Farr back there from the police department. And we have, from the fire department, we have two guys there.
Yeah.
We have two chiefs. And Baba, who else is here? Let me see. Paul Ferguson, yes. Our friend Paul Ferguson is there. Okay. And from Parks and Recreations. And we have back there, let me see, that girl who is, oh, okay, that's Marcy Foster. And we have there the deputy county manager for police and fire, James Schwartz. And please, if there's any other department head, to stand up so that I can see who you are. And then we have here assistant county manager, Raul Torres. He's my boss. And as I keep identifying you, I'll point to you. Okay, moving along, I am going to introduce to you our keynote speaker today. Keynote speaker today is a judge advocate of the Army National Guard. He's also a commander of the JAG detachment. He has served and he's serving as vice president of the Hispanic National Bar Association. He is currently serving as Deputy Secretary of Veterans and Defense Affairs of Virginia. He's part of the staff of Governor McAuliffe. And guess what? He lives in Arlington. He lives in Arlington. So you never know where you're gonna find around here. So I'm gonna call Jaime Araizaga Soto to come forward and give us his keynotes. Thank you, Jaime, for coming.
I think this one's working too, so I might as well save battery. Good, buenas tardes a todos, good afternoon. It's good to be home. As I was just introduced, I've lived in Arlington for a number of years, and 2 years ago, I had the honor of being invited by Governor McAuliffe to his administration. So I'm one of two Arlingtonians serving at the governor's office in Richmond. The other one many of you would know, which is serves as a delegate of North Arlington for many, many years, Bob Brink. Bob is in the policy shop, and I am serving with the governor. Very humble. The Virginia State Capitol is a beautiful building in Richmond, designed by Thomas Jefferson, and it has five office windows in the front. The one on the right is the governor's ceremonial office, where every governor of Virginia has worked until Mark Warner, and then we had the Patrick Henry restored a building across the street, so that's where the governor's day-to-day office is. But you have the ceremonial office of the governor, you have the cabinet room, where every Monday morning the governor meets with the cabinet, the reception, and then you have the humble office of this jibarito, of this Puerto Rican hillbilly, an Arlingtonian right there. And then Secretary Harvey, who was a commander of fleet forces, spent 39 years in the US Navy, retired as a four-star admiral, and he's our secretary. So I'm very humbled to represent you and all those that have served or continue to serve, and every Virginian as the deputy secretary of the governor for Veterans and Defense. I'm glad to be here. I know last year I tried to be here, but I was activated for a week to another great place in Virginia called the Army JAG School, which is in Charlottesville. As it was pointed out, I serve as an Army JAG, which is a military lawyer. My unit is in George Mason at the Army Readiness Center, where the Army National Guard headquarters are, right next to the Foreign Service Institute here in Arlington. So my unit is in Arlington. But last year I had to go for a week to the JAG School in Charlottesville, but I understand another great member of the administration. She lives in Alexandria, but that's okay. Maribel Ramos, who heads the governor's office in Washington. She was here last year with you. I want to commend Maribel for your leadership and for putting the event forward. I want to thank our leaders, because I'll be talking very quickly because I don't have that much time, but I wanted to really commend our elected leaders. When you look at the 130 localities throughout Virginia and you look at their quality of life and you look at where Arlington is, I remember when the gentleman that does the radio show on NPR every day on radio, Kojo Namdi, came to Arlington and interviewed. I remember my little entry was, well, we got great leaders, so that's how you get great decisions made. And I'm really humbled by the leadership of our county board and our school board, because as having sat over here in the Arlington County Transportation Commission for many nights until past midnight on that clock, deciding, it is the citizens and our leaders that have made Arlington what we are. And I am very humble, and I commend the leadership of Arlington for that. Well, there's something about Arlington that makes us unique, and we should all be proud of our history here in Arlington. It's a long history. When you look at that hill coming across the river, and you look at that house, which many call Arlington House, the Costis Lee Mansion at Arlington Cemetery, you realize how much history we have. When you understand that when President Lincoln became president in 1861, after winning the elections of 1860, Robert E. Lee was offered the command of the Army of the Potomac. And he went back to that house and resigned his commission as an officer of the United States Army. He had gone to West Point, and he moved south to Richmond, where I'm at now. And it is also here in Arlington, where we had the Fritzman Village, which is such a pride of our history for us. You can keep moving along and understand that Arlington has been unique even in Virginia's history, because it was Arlington's leadership not that long ago that decided to integrate our high schools and had to challenge our schools and had to challenge Richmond and the Virginia establishment to do so. So, and it was not too long ago right here where our board decided that in spite of what is known as 1087G, a Department of Homeland Security decision to make every police officer and every law enforcement officer in the United States implement the immigration laws. It was this county and it was this board that said, not in Arlington. Our police works with our community, not against our community. And we took a very tough stand on that issue, but it's come to show only a few years later that Arlington was on the right side of history once again. So I say that because we should all be very proud of our history and what all of our communities, Latinos, non-Latinos, continue to do to make Arlington what it's been, really a beacon of progress in the nation and particularly in Virginia. You only have to go 102 miles south to my office and see how different discussions and the dialogue is about how to work together or not, how to treat different members of our community, including those that have come more recently, or those that speak a different language, or those that look somewhat different. And so I commend Arlington, and I tell this to you, be very proud of what we've done, and I'm so honored to be here with my fellow Arlington Latinos to commemorate together with the employees of the county and the leadership of the county, Hispanic Heritage Month. Three messages for this celebration is what has been chosen by Alianza: embracing, enriching, and enabling. Embracing. Oh, do we know how to embrace in Arlington? Huh? I've already indicated our history, and I think that when we look at our schools, Key School, or we look at our festivals, or we look at our comunidad, we see how Arlington embraces not only Latinos, but all those from different walks of life, whether different origins, different races, different sexual orientations. Arlington knows how to embrace, and I think our community shows it, because by just coming to Arlington, you're embracing Arlington. Many people say, oh, I'm a Virginian. I say, I am. I'm a Virginian by choice. I might not be by birth, but I'm by choice. I chose to come to Arlington. I choose to stay in Arlington. And that shows how our community embraces Arlington. Enriching. Well, I was just asked by the leadership, how are you doing in Richmond? And I said, hey, it's a great city, but doesn't have the richness of Arlington. And it doesn't mean that I get to speak less Spanish there than I do here. It means that when you take that Columbia Pike, or when you take this Wilson Boulevard, or when you take this George Mason, what you're seeing is a rich tapestry. And if you want to have some good pho, I can find you some good Vietnamese pho in many places of Arlington. And if you want to find some good kebab, you're going to find some good kebab. And I never leave Arlington without stopping first at Super Pollo right there, because I need to have my good chicken before I head south. Okay? So by enriching, I think it is shown. It is shown by the beautiful national anthem singing. Señora, felicidades por su hija. Young lady, you make us proud. That's an Arlingtonian leading the way. Thank you, that was beautiful. So that is enriching our community. To have somebody Believe me, as an Army colonel, I've seen a lot of great presentations of the national anthem. I had never seen somebody doing double duty by doing the national anthem and sign language. Felicidades. So that's embracing, that's enriching, enabling, okay? As the son of an elementary school teacher, anybody that's in education here, raise your hand. Anybody in education, including our school board leader? Well, gracias, because that's enabling. That young lady has been enabled by our Arlington County Public Schools, also by the love of her parents, but by our Arlington County Public Schools to do the great presentation she did. Enablers is what every one of you do, because you, instead of being in the private sector, which we are big fans of the private sector in Virginia and in this administration, but you have made a conscious decision to be in a position to serve the common good. And I call that enabling. Whether it's in the county board, in the school board, whether it's in our transportation division, our social services, our law enforcement, every one of you has decided, I want to be in the public sector. My mom was an elementary school teacher. My dad was in economic development. So I have seen this vocation for our common good, for our Arlington way, ever since a little kid. And I think every one of you personifies that enabling. It's a government that works not to hinder individual capacities and individual innovation, but to enable those talents and that innovation to allow for the common good of all of us. So when I saw the enabling, I see the good side. All of you are enabling our Arlingtonians and our society, whether it's sitting down and deciding whether the stop sign should be in one corner or the other corner. Believe it or not, that stop sign might save somebody's life 2 years down the road. Whether it's to paving one street or the other, all those issues are quality of life, and that's why, in a way, we're the envy of so many, not only in the Beltway, not only in Virginia, not only in the nation, but worldwide. It's the work that you do every day to enable our community to be better and better. There's a challenge, you know? These are difficult days for our community in many areas of the nation. We are here in Arlington, which in a way it's a cocoon, fortunately. Our community over the last year has been criticized, even demonized in many cases. But I am proud to be here with my fellow Arlingtonians to celebrate the work that so many of your fellow employees, so many of our residents do day in and day out, and show you that we embrace, that we enrich, and that we enable. Our community in Arlington, I remember from the reports that we would get in the Arlington County Transportation Commission, and I just heard we're at 15%. It's their natural processes, you know. Some people move, different situation. I do think that those of us that are here, whether it's in the schools or whether they're in the labor force, we, as we always say, it's important to have a hand up and a hand back. Somebody's gonna help you move up, and I commend the Latinos that are in leadership in the county. And I remind all of you to always take a hand back. That's how that young lady has already gotten as far as she has gotten, and she's just starting. And the same way so many of you are moving up. So the enabling challenge, which I will close, is to educate and let people know, because in this dialogue, sometimes destructive, remember the facts, remember the people that are working day in and day out in your team and all around the nation for the good of all of us. And then as we enable, we have to enable not only within our community, but within other communities, the greatness of Arlington and the greatness that we see in our community. Our community is very diverse. It's very interesting. So we had somebody dancing over here, the young man. I commend you. Where's my jarocho? There you go. And for many Latinos, they might have never seen that dance, because our community is so diverse. I think he's jarocho from Veracruz, correct? But the dance, Yes, yes. So I, you know, Mexico has 32 states, and they are as diverse as, and that's just one country. And as was indicated, we come from all across the hemisphere, with a commitment to family and a commitment to hard work. And I commend you, young man, on your work. But I'll leave you with that. Remember, we embrace Arlington, we enrich Arlington, and we enable others and us to keep Arlington moving together. Be proud of being an Arlingtonian, be proud of being a diverse, and be very proud of our leaders. Stay engaged, and in, what is it, 55 days, make sure you all vote. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Jaime. I would like to also tell you that we as Hispanics were very diverse. We greet change as a friend. We're always in the midst of change, one way or another. And we are a resource group. And we cross lines, and we help others. We mingle with other groups. And we try to make sure that as we are being enabled, we enable others, and we help others. I want to introduce to you one person that I just want you to recognize, because she is leading a new resource group, and the Hispanic Alianza group is behind her. Her name is Hope Halleck. She is the chair of the new LGBT resource group of employees in Arlington County. Thank you very much, Hope. We're very diverse, we're everywhere. We have musicians, we have artists, we have some politicians now, recently. We're being enabled left and right, and who knows what kind of impact we're making in America we will make. Many of you know Pablo Casals is Hispanic. Raquel Welch, she was born Raquel Tejada in Chicago. She's Hispanic. But none of you probably knew that. Andy Garcia, artist. Ricardo Montalban, artist. Well, now I'm going to present somebody. Her name is Martha Sanchez. She is originally from the Dominican Republic. She's a computer engineer. She works for DHS. And she's a mother, and she wanted me to say that. She's also a grandmother. I just said it, we're moving along. And she was also a firefighter and a captain. So why don't you put some fire here and give us a little bit of your art.
We can actually see now how fast we can switch. It's not like it's gonna be so mixed, but just enjoy, and if you feel the urge to dance.
Siempre, como ya es costumbre, día a día es igual. No hay nada que decir, ante la gente es así. Amigos, simplemente amigos, sin nada más. Pero quién sabe en realidad lo que sucede entre los dos. Si cada quien llegando a la noche finge un adiós. ¿Cuánto daría por gritarles nuestro amor? Decirles que al cerrar la puerta nos amamos sin control. Que despertamos a con ganas de seguir amándonos, pero es que en realidad no acepta nuestro amor.
¿Usted quiere bailar?
Siempre, con mirada siempre nos damos todo el amor. Hablamos sin hablar, todo es silencio en nuestro andar.
amigos, simplemente amigos y nada más. Pero quién sabe en realidad lo que sucede entre los dos. Si cada quien llegando a la noche finge un adiós. ¿Cuánto daría por gritarles nuestro amor? Decirles que al cerrar la puerta nos amamos sin control. Que despertamos abrazados con ganas de seguir amándonos. Pero es que en realidad no aceptan nuestro amor.
¡Eso! ¿Pueden venir acá también?
Sí.
Thank you very much to the audience. This was not part of the show, of the program, but it turned out very nice. Just remember. Just remember that we are the largest ethnic minority in the United States. We represent 18% of the population, and we are very diverse, but there's something that united us. We're united by food, we are united by music, we're united by dancing. Thanks to all of you for joining. We will have food upstairs on the 9th floor. Your program has a ticket. Just make sure that you bring your program with you and show it there. There's a variety of foods from different countries. I hope you can enjoy that. I'm gonna bring one of the Alianza members who is the vice president of Alianza. Alianza is an organization that started as a group of employees, has become a civic group. We're a nonprofit organization here to help not only Arlingtonians, but also to help each other. I'm gonna leave you with Efrain Frank Colon, who will give us a closing words. And after that, this is gonna be a gozadera videotape and head upstairs for the food.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you one thing. I never got paid for dancing, but it felt pretty good. I do have to say one thing again, like I was here last year. Fire department, my friends, the Trade Center, everybody here. I mean, it's all those speeches. You see this piece of paper? Everybody said everything. Sometimes it's good to speak from the heart, like I did last year, because every time I come up here, the last guy, you know, everybody said all the good words. But it ain't the good words. Is everybody in this room, if you really, really look at who you are, I mean, somebody came here somewhere. My white, my black, my friends, my Puerto Ricans, my Irish, Italianos, depending who you are. But you know, everybody came from somewhere. People say, I was very impressed the other day, the fire department. I work for the equipment bureau. There ain't that many tradesmen around here. This suit was rented, just a joke. But a fire pumper came to the equipment bureau, and I was amazed. You know what I was amazed about? Because I sat there, and I wasn't even thinking. And I'm sitting there, a beautiful truck comes, a pumper. I'm gonna get 10 bucks out of you, buddy. But you know, and I looked at it, and the men and women that came off there, it was a woman, it was a Hispanic, it was a black person with dreads. It was an American Indian with a ponytail. And I'm saying to myself, talk about diverse. I mean, it just felt great. You know, what you guys have here is just, I gotta give kudos when it belongs. I mean, that was, people have to see what we have. And I mentioned that last year because it's great when you have a lot of people with different nationalities and we all work together. But your guys, Arlington County always brings it to that, excuse the expression, goddamn great level. And that great level is, you know, it's beautiful, because I got my black brother, I got Muslim. I had a Muslim the other day, a beautiful person. He comes to me, you know what he says, Frank? He's new. He says, Frank, you mind if I pray? I said, what are you talking about? Am I religion? I said, sure. I said, you know, we can do that. He says, would there be a problem? I said, no, not in Arlington County. Not in Arlington County. And I repeat that 3 times. But we didn't take his heritage away. We didn't take nothing. He came here, and we gave him what he loved. And he worked with us, but he's great. But you know, when I was watching him, he says, thank you very much. But that's all of you. That's everybody in this room. You made this atmosphere. You made the good. You made people feel comfortable. You didn't take their heritage away from them at all. But there's one thing we do have. And I always say, I'm from 1800s. My family came from Spain. We went to Puerto Rico. My grandfather was, you know, he owned a plantation. Red hair, green eyes. Do I got red hair, green eyes? No. So he married a native, a Puerto Rican, beautiful woman. They had kids and blah, blah, blah. We moved to New York. I'm from Brooklyn. I was born, Lord, that was great, you know. I wouldn't be here. But the only thing I'm trying to say, everybody in this room came from somewhere. Irish, green eyes, dark complected, beautiful hair, beautiful, you know, you have to look around you. You know, and we all, I love this Arlington. You know, I mean, your people, you just gotta embrace it. I mean, you have to say to yourself, God damn, this is a great place. And you know something, I never had a job like this. You know, I look at my president and her staff are just totally fantastic. I mean, the only thing I want to say, there's so much to say, but you know, I do have to say, I'm getting old, my glasses. LGBT, that's one of the greatest things that I saw and how they treat people. It don't matter what your preference are, but we treat them as equal. We gave them love, we gave them respect, and we're still going to support each one of them. Whatever you're black, whatever nationality you are, we're going to support you, because we're not going to take what you are and what you believe in, you know? But I'll leave you with one thing. See, all my years, I'm coming back to my heritage. People say, the kid from Brooklyn. Oh, I'm Puerto Rican. Salsa, rice and beans, my soul, my life. This is the way I grew up. But you know one thing? After so many generations, I am what a product is from the 18th century, from Spain to Puerto Rico to New York to Virginia. My son, you never guess what nationality he is. Irish, Portuguese, and German. Can you imagine that? People say, wow, why isn't he Puerto Rican? Because at the end of our life and our cycle, and the reason why we all here, we all have one thing in common. We come to this country, we made it great. All your nationalities, all your families, we, this great, great fabric of unity, diverse people, all your family. Somebody in your family came here, somebody in your family came here. Remember when you were a kid, you were in the first grade and your mother said, you better go to school, you're gonna be somebody. You did, you became somebody. But we all come to one root at the end. People say, we all are here, we love America, and America is all of you, all what you believe in, and never forget your roots, your love, and your love for your country. It is for the Hispanics, it's for the white, it's for everybody. But you have to feel that like I feel it, because, hey, I'm coming to my age, I'll be retiring pretty soon. But I know one thing, I'm probably the first one that had an American flag in front of this Arlington County, who knows? But I tell you one thing, this is what it's all about. The country will love us forever, and we'll love the country. I'm gonna turn this over to my president. Thank you very much, and God bless.
Embracing, enriching, and enabling. And we wanna ask Jaime to come forward, as well as Martha, and Mayari, and also Fernando. We have some certificates of appreciation for you here. On behalf of the Alianza, Alliance of
Hispanic employees of Arlington County, we thank you for being here today. Thank you, Fernando. Mayeri, where are you? Martha. And now I'm enabling you to go and have a good meal upstairs. Thank you very much for being here. Happy Hispanic Heritage Month.
I just want to remind everybody before they leave, in order to get into the employee lounge, you must have your program because your little ticket is on there. Thank you.
Yes.